and welcome to getyourrestaurant.com. I'm Gopal Kamat. I'm a hotelier and a restaurant owner and founder of getyourrestaurant.com, where we help you to set up a restaurant of your own and create another source of income, another source of business, and earn a lot of money, frankly speaking. So today I am giving you a special presentation, a very, very important presentation on the path to open your own restaurant. I had put a survey a couple of weeks back, in which I had asked all the people about what are your major challenges you're facing to open your own restaurant. And the question which kept up cropping again and again was that a lot of people asked me, Gopal, how should we focus on opening the location? How should we select the location for my restaurant? So I thought about it a lot of time, and according to my experience, as you know, I have a lot of restaurants of my own. So how would be the thought process? So I thought I'd give you straight away the three main things which you can focus on while you are finding your location for your restaurant. So I have named it conveniently as a location finder. So the location finder, the activity is to look at all the three things while finalizing on the location. So the number one thing which I feel should be important while finalizing the location for your restaurant is that the restaurant should be very easy to reach for your customers, for your guests. A lot of times restaurants are closed because of this important reason. The restaurant is very far away, and the restaurant is far away for the majority of the people. I am not saying that restaurants in far away places don't work, but then it has to be practical. The distance from the city center, the distance from the residential area has to be pretty near, so that it is easy for them to drive there and come back. Unless and until you are opening a dhaba on the highway, that's a different issue. I'm talking about the city restaurants, the restaurants where you can focus on the majority of the population to come to your restaurant and have food. So this is a drawing. Just forget the drawing which I have drawn over here, but then I know it's looking very ugly, but then the guests or the customers, it should be very easy for them to reach your restaurant. That will help them to come again and again and eat at your restaurant, and that will increase the restaurant sales. The second most important thing which you have to focus on is there should be nearby restaurants where you are planning to open your own restaurants. Why I am focusing, I know it is a little bit a no-brainer or a very simple thing, but I have seen again and again that people miss simple things. That's why they totally put their restaurant to the ground. They open at a place which has nothing to do in the restaurant. So the location where, if there are a lot of restaurants, that means that the spot is proven, and if the spot is proven, people who come to that location will visit one restaurant once, will visit the other restaurant once, so it is a variety for them also. So if there are a lot of restaurants at one joint, there will be a lot of people coming to the location, because then they will feel that they will visit one or the other restaurant. So make sure that there are a lot of restaurants nearby, or at least in the walking distance, so that, or in the driving distance, so that it becomes easy for the customer to choose from a variety of people. It's like you going on shopping. You don't go shopping to a place which has no stores nearby. You go to a place which has got a lot of shops, so you can window shop once, you can go and you can say, of course I do the same, my wife does the same. So make sure that you are putting your restaurant, you are selecting a location which has got other restaurants nearby, not joined together, but at least nearby. The third and the most important thing which I think you should focus on while selecting a location is that the restaurant area should be nearby a thickly populated location. There are two reasons why I have selected this point, which is I think very crucial. First is, it ties up to my first point, it is easy for the customers to reach you. And the second thing which I think is very important is easy for you to serve the customers in their house, to give home deliveries. They can come to your place and do banquets, or they can come to your place and do birthday parties and all that. So it is very easy for them. This ties to this first point. This total point which is there ties to your first point of easy to reach, but at the same time your home deliveries are very important. They can call for if they are coming to your place and having food. Sometimes it happens that they are watching match in their house, cricket match or anything, and they just want to call. So if they call, it should be easy for you to deliver food to their house. This is the building which I have drawn. I hope you like it. So if it is very far, the populated area is very far, it will take a lot of time for you to deliver there. There will be a lot of complaints, and then the food going cold and all that stuff. So make sure that all these three things are taken care of when you are planning to find the location for your restaurant. I hope you have liked this, and make sure you join us on my next episode for Get Your Restaurant, where I am going to focus on the most important aspect, that is the finance of your, how to get finance for your restaurant, and how to raise finance, and how to raise the capital in order to start your own restaurant without mortgaging your house. There are a lot of ways in which you can raise capital, and I can give you my views on it. There is a disclaimer, I am not giving you any financial advice. I am just trying to give you my views on how you can raise finance for your restaurant without mortgaging. So make sure you join us on the next episode. Thank you so much for watching Get Your Restaurant. Thanks. Take care. Bye-bye.